Hello, Mr. Nygren here. So, I'm gonna show you Game of Thrones Enhanced. Okay, we'll go to ModB. So, and then we'll click on Files, Game of Thrones. Okay, so we have the Game of Thrones Total War Enhanced mod here. I've released an update for it in February and then another one in May. So in May I just added the music submod patch and fixed some issues. But in February I released a big update. So it's still named 5.6, just like in February. I believe on February 21st, 2021, I released the Game of Thrones Total War Enhanced version 5.5. But it only worked well on Windows 7. It had a lot of issues on Windows 10. Because of custom settlement files not working well on Windows 10, causing a crash every time players would try to fight real-time battles in certain cities. I believe the Wooden Castles and Motten Baileys, I believe, were the cause most of the time, and Moat Cailin, which was a custom settlement. Okay, so I fixed that and released 5.6. But then it would seem that 5.6 has some other issues. It had, a Silver Surfer Jorah Mormont for House Targaryen. It had a Silver Surfer Harry Strickland for the Free Cities of Essos faction. And it had, I believe, the Golden Company Elephants were available in two cities on the map. In Myr in Essos, which is fine, and then also in King's Landing. But the mod is taking place during Season 2 and 3. So, during the War of the Five Kings. Book 2 and 3 as well. And I believe the Golden Company elephants only arrived in the books in Westeros in later seasons. I mean, in later books. And In the show, they arrived in the final season without their elephants. Okay, and I felt it was wrong for Lannisters to get them from King's Landing while no one else in Westeros had them, because they are really strong and OP. But it's okay for the Free Cities of Essos to have elephants, because they are fighting House Targaryen, and House Targaryen, as you know, has dragons. So. Okay, so we removed the elephants from Westeros, and we removed and we fixed the Silver Surfers, the two heroes that were Silver Surfers, and then I also did some other changes. But the main feature was that I added the music submod. Okay, so Game of Thrones Total War Enhanced had some other issues. I tried to play some, and I believe I did three videos on YouTube. One video where I showed all the changes of the mod, and then another one that was originally part of the first video. The first video were originally at 2 hours 45 minutes long, or 49 minutes long, but I had to cut 49 minutes because, or about 45 minutes or something, because I had a crash battle, and I didn't want that crash to be in the preview, so I cut it just before the crash. Okay, so the game can still crash in battle randomly, even with the Medieval 2 Total War Engine Overhaul Project tool. So the game, thanks to the new map, is extremely stable on the map, so it will go on for hundreds of turns, maybe even thousands. I've played 800 turns and 1000 turns, etc. When letting the AI play, I've let it go on for over 3000 turns in the past. But the latest version at least has been going on for 400 turns without crashing. So the map should be stable, unlike the old version. But when it comes to battles, they could randomly crash. And in custom battle, I had a lot of CTD until I started to use the Medieval 2 Total War Engine Overhaul Project tool, which made battles much more stable. So I had no CTD in custom battle after using the tool. However, I still crashed during that preview video. So it is still possible that the mod can crash during battle randomly, but the tool will fix any creature or giant unit. So if, for example, if you have giants, dragons or mammoths or elephants in your army, then it was way more likely to crash in prior versions of the mod, but now it, thanks to the tool, it will never crash because of those units, because the creature is fixing those units. It is fixing the skeletons of such units, so they won't ever crash. So now you can play battles with dragons, mammoths, elephants and giants without having to worry about a crash. However, the game can still crash even if you don't have those units in the battle, if you're unlucky, but the tool will make those CTT or crashes to desktop much more rare. So I tried starting up the game again and played the battle and it worked fine. Then I played another battle, as you saw in that video if you have seen it, where I didn't crash. And then I played some more without recording and it didn't crash. So CTD should be much more rare thanks to the tool, and the giant units and creatures shouldn't crash at all. Okay, so we have removed the CTD on the map, we have removed the CTD connected to elephant units or units based on elephants, and the CTD in battles have been made more rare and uncommon. Okay, but they still can happen. Then there were another issue in battle, and that was the fact that it lagged a lot, quite a bit, when I fought the battle. And I found that the reason is the Medieval 2 Total War Engine Overhaul Project tool. That's what I want to talk about now. So we have Game of Thrones Total War Enhanced version 5.6 re-upload fixing issues. So this is the only version of the mod you need. You do not need Westeros 1.0 or any other version of Westeros for this mod to work. It's not a sub-mod anymore. So this Game of Thrones mod, it states Game of Thrones sub-mod for Westeros Total War. Then you will have to keep in mind that this mod was released originally by Inarus, this user, in 2011. Back then, Game of Thrones Enhanced was an art mod and a sub-mod of the oldest version of Westeros Total War. I believe Westeros Total War Alpha version 0.53, or if it was 0.54. So originally, this mod required the Alpha of Westeros Total War in order to work, but that's no longer the case. It's not been the case since 2016. This mod is now standalone and only requires this mod to be downloaded, and then you can play it immediately. So if you go to Medieval 2 Total War Kingdoms mod, you can if you click on moddb.com here, this is the front page of moddb.com. Okay, then you search for Game of Thrones. Let's see here. Total War Enhanced. Maybe not enhanced then. Okay, Game of Thrones, Fire and Blood, Game of Thrones mod. There are a few for different games. I believe this is the one, Game of Thrones submod. Let's check it. No, that was the wrong one. It was the submod of this submod, of a very old version released in 2017. In Game of Thrones. Let's see here. And this is probably the one that wasn't released. Alright, the most easy thing you can do, just write Medieval 2. Then you get here, then you go to mods, and then you will find Game of Thrones in this list. So Game of Thrones is the mod, no other mod using Westeros or whatever. Just click on Game of Thrones there with the black symbol, and then we'll get to this page. Game of Thrones submod for Westeros Civil War, released 2011. That's the right page. Then you can read this article to learn how to install it. So, Game of Thrones Civil War Enhanced version 5.6, Windows 10 compatible, released. Hello, the 5.5 update had serious issues on Win 10 and would CTD crash the desktop in many siege battles due to custom settlement files. I've had to remove certain files in those folders to make the mod run on Win 10 without this issue. But Kaelin, which was a custom settlement made by McAnyane for Westeros 1.0, had to be removed, sadly, but the rest are working. So all the other custom settlements by McAnyane, including the Castle Black custom settlement never used in another mod before, is working in this mod. So we have King's Landing, we have Dragonstone, and we have Castle Black. Then we also have our skin of Highgarden. Okay, they were made by McAnyane for Westeros 1.0. Okay, I've also added new merchants, priests, diplomats, and ships from P-Man, which is the creator of Game of Thrones, Total War, Fire and Blood, with his permission, among other things. Redownload, delete version 5.5, which didn't work for on Windows 10, and insert this instead. Has quality of life changes now too since 10th May 2021. I've re-uploaded a mod with the new updated version of the M2TWEOP-tool, which is the Medieval Total War Engine Overhaul Project tool. Changes include, and it's the version from December 3, 2020, because any other version after that doesn't have the creature fix that I need for certain units to not crash. Of course, those units can still work fine on Windows 7, without the tool, but on Windows 10 they are very likely to crash. Okay, changes include many stability issues. Well, I don't need to read this because this is the changes of the tool from December 2020. But we can go down here. So on some Windows 10 computers you may need to do this. It might be hard to see, but I believe when you start the game, you no longer use the executable.bat, it's been removed. Instead you use the M2TWEOP tool, which follows with the mod. So you download the mod. Let's go back to this. You scroll down, you can read this to learn how to install it and all that. There's also a shortcut in the article where you can click. If you click here, you get to the download. And this is the download of the actual mod. You can also click here, download now, and you can also download the music mod here. And this article has all the info about changes in the latest version and update, and has all the installation instructions too. But if you go, you can click on these links in the article to get to the download, or you can go down. You need to go back to the start page, then I had clicked on the article. If you click on the article, you get the ingress here, and can read the entire article and see the comments and such, but there are no files down here. If you are on the start page, however, you have most of the article, and then when you go down, you find comments in here too, but there are a file section and an article section. So you have older articles beneath the latest article, and then for older versions, 5.5 and others, and then files. We have a lot of old files here. Okay, and the latest two files, May 10, 2021, is the Game of Thrones Civil War Enhanced version 5.6, re-upload fixing issues, and the GOT submod 5.6, season 1 and 2 and 3 soundtrack. If you click on this download or use the links in the article you get here, you can see file name GOT.1.rar. The reason it's a 1 here is because it's the second upload without re-uploading the entire mod. At first I uploaded version 5.6, then I overwrote it, and because I overwrote it with a fixed version, I got a number here. So if I do that again, I will get number 2 and then 3 and then 4. I can also delete the upload and upload something from scratch, then it will just be named GOT.rar. Okay, so we can see category full version. So this is standalone. It doesn't need any, it doesn't require any other mod to work or any other version to work. It's been added on March 9th, 2021, because I updated, I fixed the mod on March 9th. I believe the 5.5 version were uploaded on February 21, and then the 5.6 version on March 9th. And then I uploaded the latest fixes on May 10th. Okay, the size is 2.79 gigabyte. 3,552 people have downloaded it. Okay. Okay, but let's go down to business. You click, you can click on read more to read instructions here too and changes, but I suggest reading the article. It's more detailed and more completed. I believe this was written before the article was made, and the article is better and provides more info. I also believe this version, this text doesn't, I believe the M2TWEOP-tool isn't mentioned here, because this is from the version I released in March, where I hadn't implemented the tool for this mod yet. Okay, I did it because I thought the battles would be more stable. I tried to play custom battle without the tool and I crashed all the time. Then I played with the tool and I didn't crash. So it was when I recorded some battles. Okay, so you click download, then you need WinRAR to download this mod and other mods. So go to Google, write WinRAR. The first thing you will get is this one. Click there. And then you can download WinRAR. You do not need to buy anything, just download it, okay, and install it anywhere on your computer, doesn't matter where. By the way, when you have installed WinRAR, you get this symbol for any archive that is using the WinRAR format. So this is the WinRAR archive symbol. So any file with this symbol is a WinRAR archive, and it might have different files in it, but it's using the WinRAR file format. Okay, let's see here if we have any GOT. So when you have downloaded the mod, then you click on this GOT, and this will show up. Then you will get this splash screen saying that you should buy WinRAR. Just exit it. You do not need to buy anything. It's free to use. Then you have the mod there, GOT. So the mod folder is named GOT, not GOT1 or something. So if you, for example, right-click this file and then extract to GOT3, or as it would be if you download this file, GOT1, then when you right-click that file, GOT1, then you would have the option extract to GOT1. You can do that. That will create a folder, a normal folder, a yellow folder like this, named GOT1. But the mod folder is not named GOT1, it's named GOT. So then you would need to go into the GOT1 folder and then move out the GOT folder. Another way of doing this is to double click the archive and drag the folder out of the program. You can also use the buttons here, file, and then you can extract it through these commands, but I never do that. So in my case, so we have so I have Steam installed on new volume here. Then I go to Steam apps, common, medieval total war, where I need to have, by the way, a medieval2.exe file and a kingdoms.exe file. This kingdoms.exe file isn't there after installation, because unlike the CD version, there were no kingdoms expansion in the Steam version. It followed with the Steam version, so it's just a medieval2.exe file in the Steam version. You need to right-click on the medieval2.exe if you haven't done this already. Then you need to copy the file, and then you need to rename it into kingdoms. So it looks like this. You should have one file named medieval2.exe and one file named kingdoms.exe. Then it will work on Steam. With the CD version, you already have both the files here, so you don't really need them. And in the CD version's case, you go to the wherever you have placed it, usually games, Sega, Medieval Total War, and mods, and then you just extract the mod folders into the mods location here. So, for example, Game of Thrones would be placed here. You would drag this here, and then you could start it, and let's see. So I seem to have moved it out of this folder. Okay, but what you need to do is you need to move it like this, and then wait on this to extract. As you saw, you don't need to use the commands here. You just click on this folder after opening the archive and move it out of it by dragging the folder with your mouse, or you can do the other thing and extract the folder into a normal folder named got1.rar, but it will be just named got1 then. And then you open that folder, and then you cut the GOT folder out of it and place in the mods folder. So now we are moving out the GOT folder from this archive. I will just show you how it's done. I will delete it later because I don't really need the mod in this folder. I have it on the Steam version instead. So I have some of the mods on the CD version and some on Steam, but I prefer Steam because the immersion mod which I'm using when playing doesn't work on the CD. Okay, I don't know if this is the latest version of Game of Thrones Total War Enhanced. We'll see. So this will take a while. So the RAR archive was 2.79 gigabyte. That means the real mod size might be 4 or 5, maybe 6 gigabyte. So it's pretty big. But it's still about half the size of Hyrule Total War or Warcraft Total War. So it's not the biggest mod, but it's still big. Okay, so download WinRAR, download Game of Thrones Total War Enhanced, and then extract the GOT folder to your mods folder inside of Game Sega Medieval Total War mods for the CD version, like I'm doing now. And with the CD, you do not need to copy the executable because you already have both the medieval2.exe and the kingdoms.exe, so that's only necessary if you play with Steam, because the Steam version doesn't have the kingdoms.exe, so that's why it's required there. Okay, so this took a while. You'll have to wait. Actually, I can start recording again when it's done. See you soon. Hello, Mr. Niren here. So, the loading has finished, or almost finished. I believe this is the version from March, so it doesn't have the tool. We added it to the folder in Sega Medieval 2 mods, in the Sega Medieval 2 mods folder. So it's the CD version. We have the Game of Thrones mod here. So in the old version, we had the executable.bat here. You would start the mod by double-clicking this file. This is no longer the case. So this was version 5.6 without the new fixing, and the other version with that I released on May 10th had the fixing done, fixes. Okay, and it didn't have this executable anymore. So in Steam, instead of games, Sega Medieval Tool War mods, you would go to Steam Apps Common Medieval Tool War. And as I said, you need to copy the medieval2.exe if that's not already done, and rename the copied file to Kingdoms. Then go to Mods, and then just do the same thing here. Place the mod in this folder. So these files, third person mod and third person mod new, are two separate smaller mods made by another guy that makes it possible to play as heroes, generals in and captains in third person mode, but it doesn't work on the CD. Okay, so we will just delete this folder, it's outdated. And unlike in that version, the new version of GOT has the M2TWEOP-tool instead. And it should work fine on Windows 7. On Windows 10, it should also normally work fine, but there are some issues for some people. And that's what we were looking at here. You might need to do what's written here. So I tried it on Windows 7, no issues. I tried it with the CD version on Windows 10, no issues. But according to the creators of the tool, it is required to change some stuff for the Steam version on Win 10. You do need to right click on the medieval2.exe / kingdoms.exe and change some things in the compatibility mode. It will also need to be done with the tools.exe file. This is due to the scaling settings in Windows 10. So if you do not do this, it might still work in some cases, but for some people they've had problems with the screen being too small or being a tiny, they had an issue where the screen would be a tiny little box here in the corner, while the rest of the, I believe, window wouldn't be the game. So in order to have the full screen visible in game, or in order to have the game be widescreen and covering all of the TV screen, so to say, or computer screen, you would need to do some stuff. You would need to go to, let's see here, so we are in Steam Apps Common, Medieval Total War mods, GOT. So you would need to go back to Medieval Total War, then right click on the medieval 2.exe, then go to this area, features I believe in English, and then you would need to go to compatibility, and then you would need to put it on let's see here. You need to open the file properties. Properties is the name. So in other words, you would right click this file, go to properties, then compatibility, and then change DPI settings, and check the box and select application. Okay, so that would mean you should also check this one, but change the compatibility, change the DPI settings. So I'm using Windows 7 here, maybe it's different, but we will have to check this then. So you right click on the .exe files, and then you go to compatibility mode. Unfortunately this was in Russian, so the first step was right click on the file and click on properties. The second thing you do is you go down to this area about DPI settings. Change DPI settings is the English sentence. and check the box and select application. So you will click here and then check a box and then select the application. And this option also helps with med too for some people. Plus 20 FPS set the eye scale to control by application. So when you click, I believe you check this probably, and then you go down to this one, click there, and you get this screen, and then you can check this too and click OK. So this will fix the issue with the screen being too small and being in the corner on some on certain Windows 10 computers. So I've never done it myself, but I've been told it worked by people. So it might be done for some people. Okay, with the tool. And then another thing you need to do, because you need to do this that I just showed. You need to do it on the medieval2.exe, but also on the kingdoms.exe. And then you need to go to mods and GOT. Then you need to right-click the M2TWEOP-tool as well and do the same thing. Properties, compatibility, do the same thing. Okay, and the tool itself might be seen as a virus or a Trojan by your antivirus or firewall. So you will need to go to the control panel and then you will need to go to your firewall settings, and you will need to either make an exception for this m2tweop.exe file, or you will need to disable the firewall or antivirus. So it's either making an exception for this or disabling the firewall. Also, the UAC user account control should also be either deactivated or at least change so that it doesn't interfere with Medieval 2 modding. But usually, to get any Medieval 2 mods to work on modern computers, you will need to deactivate the UAC or user account control. But the firewalls, they will see the new M2TWEOP tool as a virus, so either make an exception for it in your firewall settings or antivirus settings, or disable the firewall and antivirus. Otherwise, the antivirus or firewall will place this tool, this .exe file, in the trash. So you can't start the mod because it's seen as a virus. Okay, when you have this file safely inside the mods folder, inside of mods GOT, and it no longer is seen as a virus by the antivirus or firewall, then you will just right click on it and start as an administrator, or you can just double click on it and then this will start. So you have the menu of the Medieval Total War Engine Overhaul project tool. So when I uploaded this mod on May 10th, I had already fixed this line. It has the same text as the configuration.cfg file of the mod, got.configuration.cfg. Okay, so this is already done. It will load the mod. You can start the vanilla game here, or you can start the actual mod on the on this upper thing. It states start vanilla, and it states start run mod. You should click run mod or start mod to start the actual mod, of course. And then there are some options here. Don't change them. Display settings, borderless window, use desktop resolution, use these settings. Okay, so just leave these as they are. You can change some stuff here if you want, but if I were you, I wouldn't mess with it unless you're a modder. And then I believe in the version I uploaded on May 10th, I had more options checked. I believe I had probably the new family tree elements checked, and I have the spawn army fix and unlock console commands. So it looks something like this. I figured that the mod lags in battle because we have too many options checked. So just deselect these. only ones you need are Berserk's fix, which is enabling the Berserk mental stance in battle, so that some Greyjoy Axemen units and the Wildling Axemen can go Berserk in battle without crashing when they reach the enemy. So you need this checked, and you also need the creature's fix checks. You need the creature's fix checked and the Berserk's fix checked. The others should be deactivated. But in order to have them deactivated, it's not enough to remove the check mark. You also need to click this this here, apply changes. So you remove them and then you click apply changes, and the tool will have these options checked the next time you start it, because the upload had too many features active, causing a lot of stuttering and some lag in battle. By removing these and applying the changes, that one too, and applying the changes, you would reduce the stuttering and the lag in battle, because in, I believe, in Warcraft of the War, I couldn't even play with the Night Elves against the Burning Legion when I had most of these options checked. But when I removed, I forgot that one too, let's apply changes. So you should only have these two checked. When you only have these two checked, then in battle it shouldn't lag and stutter, at least not as much as before. It should be almost lag free if you have a good or decent computer. I have a gaming computer from 2013 and it shouldn't lag with these settings on checked. But if I have the other checked too, it will stutter a lot and lag, just as we saw in one of the preview videos. Okay, so with these options selected and these changed to only have Berserk's fix and creature's fix enabled, then you can start the mod here. And here are some options you can change if you want, but only do that if you're a modder and know what you're doing. Okay, start the mod. So we start the mod. And Game of Thrones of Lore Enhanced will start with this in the upper corner showing that the tool is on. Alright, see ya. I don't want the music to be heard.